हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ दिव्या कुमारी मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीए पार्ट सेकेंड ईयर आर वेलकम हेयर इन द क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द लाइफ ऑफ विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ and about his major works. In the next video, we will study the poem about the poem. We will study about the poem how the word is too much with us. The poem "The World Is Too Much With Us" is written by William Wordsworth. So let us see about his life. William Wordsworth was born in 1770 and he died in 1850. He is a romantic writer. We have already discussed about the romantic age, about the characteristics of romantic era, about the theme, about the subject matter the writer writes in this particular age. The writers majorly write about, they talk about nature, and they were influenced by French Revolution. So Wordsworth was also one of them. And romantic era began with the publication of lyrical ballads, which was also written by William Wordsworth. So he is one of the major romantic writer, and he is among the he is one of the writer who lived longest life during the romantic period. On April 1770, William Wordsworth was born in Cockermouth, Cambria, England. Wordsworth's mother died when he was 8. This experience shapes much of his later work. Wordsworth attended Hogshead Grammar School, where his love for poetry was firmly established, and it is believed he made his first attempts at verse. While he was at Hogshead, Wordsworth's father died, leaving him and his four siblings orphans. After Hogshead, Wordsworth studied at St. John's College in Cambridge, and before his final semester, he set out on a walking tour of England, an experience that influenced both his poetry and his political sensibilities. While touring Europe, Wordsworth came into contact with the French Revolution. This experience, as well as the subsequent period living in France, brought about Wordsworth's interest and sympathy for the life, troubles, and speech of the common man. These issues proved to common man. Wordsworth's earliest poetry was published in 1793. In the collections An Evening Walk and Descriptive Sketches. While living in France, Wordsworth conceived a daughter, Caroline. He left France, however, before she was born. In 1802, he returned to France and his sister on a 4-week visit to meet Caroline. Later that year, he married Mary Hutchinson, a childhood friend, and they had given birth to 5 children. In 1812, while living in Grasmere, 2 of their children died. Equally important in the poetic life of Wordsworth was his 1795 meeting with the poet Samuel Taylor Coleridge. It was with Coleridge that Wordsworth published the famous Lyrical Ballads in 1798. And with the publication of this, Lyrical Ballads is regarded as the starting of Romantic period. While the poems equally important in the poetic life of Wordsworth was his 1795 meeting with the poet Coleridge. While the poems themselves are some of the most influential in Western literature, it is the preface to the second edition that remains one of the most important testaments to the poet's views on both his craft and his place in the world. In the preface, Wordsworth writes on the need for common speech within poems and argues against the hierarchy of the period which valued epic poetry above the lyric. Wordsworth's most famous work, The Prelude, is considered by many to be the crowning achievement of English Romanticism. The poem, revised numerous times, chronicles the spiritual life of the poet and marks the birth of a new genre of poetry. Although Wordsworth worked on the Prelude throughout his life, the poem was published posthumously. Wordsworth spent his final years settled at Redhill Mount in England, travelling and continuing his outdoor excursions. William Wordsworth died at Redhill Mount on April 23, 1850, leaving his wife Mary to publish The Prelude 3 months later. So this is all about the life of a very greatest writer, William Wordsworth. So in the next video, we will study about the major themes and summary of the poem, The World Is Too Much With Us, which is one of the best example of the poetry written during the Romantic period, and also it includes all the characteristics of the poetry of Romantic age.